All right, so I just finished the reading. The camera just started recording on its own. So let's just go with it. Let's go with it. You know what I'm saying? So we're going to do another read. Let's get it. Let's get into it. Stillness is what I cut the deck to just a moment ago. The writer's rap label went round. Oh, let's smoke a word. I'm about to make up my own lyrics. You know how we do. We be making our own lyrics. I was going to say, let's like smoking herb. He ain't say nothing about no smoking no herb. He ain't say nothing about smoking no herb. God ain't too cool for the safe belt. Now, I don't even know why he say safe belt. Wasn't he on a motorcycle? But anyway, first card out is trust. We got trust in the reading from yesterday. Relaxation. You know what I'm saying? Embracing. Oh, man. Come on, spirit. Thank you. Fulfillment. I just used that word in the last reading that I did just before this one. Trust. And this fulfillment is coming out underneath trust. Changes out again. That was in the last reading. It's like, and this coming out underneath relaxation. You know, this is going to be a pleasant change. You know, you're going to be able to relax. You know what I'm saying? You're going to be able to just sit back and embrace life. You know, embrace taking these risks. Embrace, walking on unfamiliar territory because you've been illuminated. Illumination is here for you. To the limit, to the far. All right, so let's get clarifiers for all of the cards out here. Whoa, blossoming abundance just came out over the trust card. So trust that blossoming abundance is coming out for you. It's coming towards you, and it's going to bring you fulfillment, as fulfillment is underneath this trust card. Oh, all tied up, and victory came out again. That was in the last reading. Wow. Trust in the strategy that you have implemented, you know, whether it be, you know, journaling or, the song playing right now is This Must Be Heaven. You're creating heaven on earth. That's where heaven and hell exist, on earth and in the mind. You can create hell on earth or heaven on earth. And you've chose to create heaven on earth because you've walked in love. You walked in integrity. You've taken accountability for, you know, anything that you have done, and you made the appropriate changes. Wow. And that's why you are ascending. That's why you are elevating. That's why you are having victory. So embrace this victory. Embrace this time. Just sit back and relax and trust and know that blossoming abundance is here for you to heal that broken heart, to heal your broken heart. Your heart was broken in the past, you know, according to the last postcard from Spirit. It's broken in the past because, you know, your dreams didn't come true, but just like this card said, you know, it's coming back around because now you're ready. Now you've grown and matured. World card. You took those risks that you needed to take, you didn't keep yourself in a box and allow people to make you afraid to live life on your own terms. Ooh. And now you singing, this must be heaven. Come on, let's go ahead and bring it on in. This must be heaven. You don't want to lose this feeling. Don't lose it. You found your higher self. That's who you singing to, your higher self. I don't want to lose you again. Oh, my baby. Oh, don't you ever leave me, higher self. Never, never die. The way you love yourself, it just feels so good. And it grows each day. And every night you say, bruh, you saw me shuffle. Didn't you see me shuffle? And didn't I bring this card up again to clarify this reading, baby? Look. It came out again. Search no more. Because that dream is coming back around. What? So we're going to read it again. Spirit say it one more time. Just like, and if Mike Jones, who? Mike Jones, who? It's something where they will repeat the, it don't even matter. We about to repeat this. She's going to read it again. She is. Isn't it amazing how things seem to come around again, like this card, full circle in ways you could not possibly have planned? You wonder how a dream could die only to be resurrected years later when you're really ready. You thought it was time back then, but your wisdom knows better than your small self, whose desires are unmet. Now here you are. Put my trust in you. Yes, I'm loving you, higher self. Yes, I'm loving you. Put my trust in you. Yes, I'm loving you. Yes, I'm loving you. Put my trust in you. Yes, I'm loving you. Yes, I'm loving you. Put my trust in you. Yes, I'm loving you. Yeah, all right, so put my trust in you. We got trust here, right? Trusting in this blossom in abundance. Trusting in the strategy that our higher self is guiding us and our ancestors are guiding us into. This fifth chakra here, I hadn't spoke about that. What's the fifth chakra? Throat. The throat. Throat. Throat.
Yes, I'm loving you.
Speaking life.
I trust in you.
That's what brought about this change. You spoke life. Spoke life. I was about to cuss. She said she's not gonna do that. She all, you know. Let's see what this one is. It better not be. This is crown chakra. I was gonna say, if this is some throat chakra stuff going on, because remember the last time we had the sacral chakra come on. Song come on. And we had the sacral chakra card in the spread. So, but it's still, you know, kind of ironic or coincidence in a way that I was speaking about a chakra and then the crown chakra came on. So again, you're getting these downloads, you know what I'm saying? Downloads of what to speak, and that is what is, you know, releasing what has had you bound. So continue to speak life. Continue to call in this illumination. Wow. Underneath broken heart is woman holding a heart. Holding that heart fully restored. Underneath that is appreciation. Okay? Appreciation. I think it was this reading where that song was playing. That Anita Baker song. No one in the world can love me like you do. Now those people are appreciating you. And they have become illuminated to who you are. And they're kicking themselves in the butt and the behind for not appreciating you when they had you. But baby, you focused on you. You know what I'm saying? I see nothing in this reading that says allow them people back in. It says, now here you are with a new opportunity to do things from a different, more mature perspective, from a leadership perspective, trusting your leadership abilities. We want you to trust that in this new opportunity for rebirth, you will be called in two directions, and the one that is unfamiliar will be the right one. So maybe that is starting your business, maybe starting that scheduling, investing in a scheduling program or software or whatever, and start putting yourself out there on the internet, advertising your business, getting that LLC, whatever, you know, go in that unfamiliar territory. Start doing those things, creating your strategy to start working for yourself, because you will be fulfilled. There will be fulfillment that comes from it. Speak. Maybe do videos talking about what it is that you do. You know what I'm saying? Because it's going to bring about the change that you want. It's going to elevate you. So take that risk. It says, in the unknown spaces, the uncharted places, infinite potential. In the unknown spaces, the uncharted places of infinite potential, we are waiting to guide you into your fullest life. Big bounty will come if you remain in the present. You have come full circle, and now you can see that everything changes and is made new and given new hope. You've come full circle. You can see that everything has changed. Everything has been made new and is given new hope. Loving you always. Whew. Just confirmation after confirmation, I feel. Period, Pooh. All right. That's three different decks I used here. I'm trying to debate if I want to use any other decks. If I want to pull from any other. Excuse me. I'll pull from this one. Came out too. Am I willing? Are you willing to take the risk? Are you willing to step in that leadership role? Are you willing to follow the illumination that you have? Because, baby, this is what the card says. You are on the edge of something great. Yes, there is risk, uncertainty, the unfamiliar path, right? And imperfections ahead. Failure is certain, and vulnerability is a requirement. On the voyage, on the journey, as we tie in both of those messages, there was failure in the past, like the card said. Back then, it didn't work out because you were operating in your small self, but now you're operating in wisdom, and you're mature, and you're ready. So you must be brave and trust. We have the trust card here with the blossom in abundance. And trust yourself more than ever before. World card, ending of the old cycle, elevating to the new. You will reach the dream that the postcard said is coming back full circle. You will reach the dream, but you must stretch yourself into a whole new level of belief, world card, and willingness in order to move forward with courage. Angel of strength from the last reading, okay? And you've had a broken heart, so it's hard. You know, it may be hard, but you got to be brave, because why? Right underneath that is the woman holding the heart. Not only is it fully restored, it's bedazzled. It got decorations on it. You know what I'm saying? And then appreciation underneath. Standing there confident and bold. Look at that. And underneath this card is happy family, which is the card number is 4. Foundation. Look, woman holding the heart is 44. So you have created and built a firm foundation. You know, you've built a family. The petition we did yesterday was to call in our true soulmates, that soul family. You're creating that, you know, people that are going to come along and help you achieve your career goals, and to help you move forward with courage. Angel of strength. Today's soul action: be brave, follow your heart's compass, and lift the lid on your own dreams. Today's mantra: it's possible. 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 It's the mantra. Repeat it. Repeat it. Repeat it. Repeat it. Repeat it. Repeat it. Get it in your soul. Get it in your spirit. It's possible. It's possible. It's possible. I just look down. It says, do I believe I'm worthy? Do I believe I am worthy? I'll just go ahead and read it. You are worthy. You are deserving. You are loved. Start seeing the divine beauty within you and go out and claim the life you have dreamt up. Your crown has been bought and paid for. Put it on your head and wear it. Maya Angelou. And the crown chakra music just went off, right? For you, tell me if you want me to, if you want my time, good for you. Spirit said they want to make it good for you, because you blowing their mind with how you done bossed up. They promise you that they'll be true. They say, tell me if you want me to. Do you know you're worthy? Do you believe you're worthy? Something got me so excited. Been holding back too long. But something got you so excited. You're on the edge of something great. You've been holding back too long, but all tied up, relaxation. You about to stop holding back. You about to start speaking life, and that's going to bring change about. Speak it. It's possible. It's possible. It's possible. Like this. And this is one opportunity that I can't miss. One opportunity that you can't miss. All for real. Sugar, sugar, all your loving. If you want me to, if you want my time, good for you, cause you blow my mind. Am I ready to let go of this bird shame? Tell me if you want me to. Maybe you have shame from taking risks in the past, but remember, the postcard said in the past you wasn't ready. But now you is. Now you is. So that this shame is probably what had you all tied up. Relax. 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 You got this. Speak life. That's going to bring in the victory to help you embrace this new life, this new opportunity. It says the feeling of shame is the lowest frequency there is. Ooh. Go ahead and learn me then, spirit. The feeling of shame is the lowest frequency there is. When you live in shame, you live in darkness. What part of you is ready to stand in the light? Change? Shit.
I guess change is good for any of us.
Whatever it takes for any of y'all to get up out the hood, I'm with you. I ain't mad at you. Got nothing but love for you. Do your thing. Spirit said they ain't mad at you. Release this shame. They not mad. They know you human. They know we make mistakes. We got change here though. First thing Tupac said. I know you ready for change, something like that. Fifth chakra, throat chakra, speaking life. I ain't mad at you. Communication of the same. How to add a hoochie with the same line. But world car, you ending that old cycle. Ready to get up out the hood. Had a Jerry curl, didn't quite learn. What part of you is ready to stand in the light? Is there any shame from the past, from a past experience that is ready to be healed? You know, like I said, back then, they didn't want you, now you're hot. They all on you. That's not what the card said, but it says, it says, you thought it was time back then, but your wisdom knows better. Okay? You thought it was time back then in the past, but your wisdom knew better, knew you wasn't ready. Okay? So release that shame. It had nothing to do with you. There was just more lessons that you need to learn. It has something to do with you, but it was out of your control. There was things that you needed to learn, and you were becoming illuminated to that. And underneath this illumination card is release, which was in the last reading. You become illuminated to that. So release the shame. Underneath the release card is protection. Release the shame. Release the fear because you're protected. I ain't mad at ya. The spirit guides say, I ain't mad at ya. They ain't mad at you. If they forgive you, forgive yourself. Forgive yourself. And understand that this voyage was written out. This journey was written out. You went through what you had to go through. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Okay, today's soul action. Heal the shame by giving it a name. Bring it to the light and let it be seen, heard, and healed. It's revival season. Replace shame with your soul's truth. My soul's truth is fill in the blank. My soul's truth is victory. My soul's truth is victory. I ain't mad at ya. I ain't mad at ya. My soul truth is I victorious. My soul truth is protected. My soul's truth is loyalty. The Anubis card came up. So, you know, he is loyal. He's a faithful friend. My soul's truth is you are a good person. You're loving. You're kind. I ain't mad at ya. I ain't mad at ya. Your soul's truth is you whole, you healed, and you're operating in oneness. I spelled oneness wrong on here, but it's all right. That's your soul's truth, is that you're whole, you're healed, and you are at one with Source. Your soul's truth is that you're worthy. At soul's truth is that you're worthy. Your soul's truth is that you are willing to take that risk. Your soul's truth is that you're on the edge of something great. You're always on the edge of something great. Blossoming abundance and trust. Healing. Wholeness. Oneness. All right, family, that's what I got for you. I hope that helped in some way, shape, form, or fashion. You know? I love you all. And until next time. I holla.